Hello friends, this is another episode from drvijayangovinda.com. Today we are going to discuss PSA, and this is an initiative from Dr. Vijayan Govinda Gupta to help you take control of your health. What is PSA? PSA is also called as Prostate Specific Antigen. It is a protein that is produced by the prostate gland. The prostate gland is an accessory sex organ which is present in the male genitalia. The male genitalia is composed of the penis, of the testes, of the prostate, and the bladder. The testes produce the sperm which enters the prostate, and the prostate produces a lot of fluid which along with the sperms produce the semen that is ejaculated out. Out of this fluid that is produced by the prostate is a protein that is the prostate specific antigen. A protein is nothing but an organic molecule composed of many different variety of chemicals, especially carbon and nitrogen, that has a lot of different kind of functions in the body. PSA is normally produced and excreted in the semen or ejaculate. Have you wondered, this white liquid semen becomes completely transparent after a while? It is this PSA that is supposed to break down this white semen into a clear liquid that allows the sperms to travel and finally provide fertility to men. What is a PSA test? A PSA test is a blood test. In this test, some blood is drawn, and in the blood sample, we detect PSA levels. Normally, all the PSA produced in the prostate will be ejaculated out, and a very few amount of PSA is actually left in the blood. But in diseases of the prostate, like prostate cancer, these levels may rise, because this PSA gets leaked into the blood and into the system. The next question is, what is normal PSA? More commonly, PSA is considered to be less than 4 nanograms per ml to be considered normal. But more recently, and especially in younger men, the new cutoff is 2.5 nanograms per ml. But there is no one normal. It is a normal range. So, if we do PSA in maybe 100 patients, 50 would have it around 1, another 50 would have it around 2, some may have it around 3. So, what they found was that if we take 100 men and we did PSA of each of these healthy men who had no prostate cancer, the range may vary from 1 to 4. There may also be a few men who may have a PSA higher than this and yet be normal. Some of the situations in which the PSA may be elevated and still be normal is, would be due to age, especially in advanced age, due to prostate size or a large prostate gland, a patient who may have infection of his prostate gland, or if the PSA test is done immediately after having sex, or if an intervention has been done into the prostate gland. In these circumstances, the PSA levels may actually be different from what they normally are. What is PSA screening? PSA screening is the buzzword today. Everywhere you go, there will be laboratories advising PSA screening as a way to detect cancer. Defined accurately, PSA screening would be doing the PSA test in healthy people. Healthy means that you have no disease, no problem, and you just walk into a lab and get your PSA done. The reason given for doing PSA screening is that it helps to detect prostate cancer early and hence provides you an option to get early treatment and prevent these bad effects of prostate cancer. But does it really happen? United States Preventive Services for Task Force recommends against PSA screening, and very strongly so. And it has been so strong that PSA screening has almost disappeared from the United States. But at the same time, other many professional bodies like the AUA, the EUA and the NCCN go ahead and recommend PSA screening. Their reasons are different, that we will discuss ahead. And they also give very varying recommendations and guidelines for the frequency and the age to get PSA screening. Are there any benefits of PSA screening? Yes. Early detection? Yes. But does PSA screening prolong life? This is the question that has been out. And to understand this, we have to understand something of a concept known as lead time bias that I will describe to you in the following diagram. For example, a man is supposed to live for 60 years and he gets prostate cancer at the age of 40. Now, prostate cancer is a slow disease. So maybe for the next 15 years or so, he suffers no harm. And at the age of 55, we find out because of his symptoms that he has prostate cancer and we diagnose it, and then he lives for another 5 years and dies. Now, if we do PSA screening and we detect prostate cancer at 40, this man will receive treatment for the next 20 years, but he will still die at 60. So even though it appears that he lived for 20 years, but actually he actually did not get any benefit in terms of survival of a living longer. On this single fact, the evidence is conflicting, and this is the reason why so many different professional societies recommend or do not recommend PSA screening. The problem of PSA screening is that a man who is anyways going to die at 60 years has to live with a diagnosis of cancer for 15 more years, which leads to unnecessary tests, unnecessary biopsies, unnecessary anxiety, and the costs. But if you have had a PSA screening done and you do not know the way forward and you are confused, I recommend that you meet a urologist. I, Dr. Vijayant Govinda Gupta, am an MCH urologist and a consultant urologist practicing in Delhi, NCR and Gurgaon. So you can take an appointment with me and we can sit and discuss the way out. Are there any other uses of PSA? Yes. Once you have been detected with prostate cancer, PSA can be used to follow up as well as to monitor treatment. PSA can be used to detect recurrence if you have received treatment for prostate cancer. And in some cases, an elevated PSA may prompt your urologist to go ahead with a prostate biopsy. The new buzzword are the variants of PSA. These variants are very often misused. Till today, there is no convincing scientific evidence that any of these variants have been found to be more advantageous over regular PSA in detecting or treating prostate cancer. But in conditions in which the PSA report is false or the PSA report does not meet the expectations of the urologist and the patient, these variants can be used to detect cancer, especially if all the tests have been negative, but still the suspicion of cancer is very high. But again, I again emphasize, till today, there is no convincing evidence which supports the PSA variants in screening. If you have received a variant test and you do not know how to proceed, then you should again meet a consultant urologist, because a urologist is the most trained person to help you out in these conditions. You can meet me, Dr. Vijayant Govinda Gupta, or visit my website drvijayantgovinda.com to clear out some doubts about the PSA that you may have, and we can always take an appointment and sit together and find a way out. Thank you.